dry for those disembarking from the Sea Lion 2000 at Penashaw, and you come to one of Kangaroo Island's premier tourist destinations, Seal Bay. Today the tourists flock to Seal Bay Conservation Park, in fact more than 100,000 each year. But back in the 50s, this was truly a wilderness experience, as Kangaroo Island legend Don Dixon knows only too well. Let's go back to the early 50s, when Don Dixon loaded up the old Packard and set off on the track taken by the early Yakka gum workers, who collected resin for shellac, varnish and explosives. They cut the old road through here, and later an intrepid tour guide followed.
The track that they made coming in here went from one Yakka to the next Yakka to the next one, which meant that it wound around all over the place. It used to take over an hour to come in from the South Coast Road down to Seal Bay here.
The signs on the way said it all, but the regular carload of tourists loved the bone-jarring trip and the experiences that awaited them at Seal Bay all those years ago.
It's been so long now, but it seems now that it was only yesterday. Gee, ain't it funny how time slips away?
Today, environmentalists would shudder at the close proximity of tourists to these marvellous creatures. But Don played a pivotal role in publicising this now world-renowned seal colony. And his underwater antics with these animals attracted national attention, when the first holiday and lifestyle shows like Sunday Magazine with Mike Schilberger went to air on Channel 9.
A local expert is the island's chief tourist guide, Don Dixon. Although most of the seals can be very vicious, Don does his best to make friends with them. Imitating a cow seal, Don is attempting to attract the attention of the big bulls.
Now this is a marine sanctuary, in large part due to the efforts of Don, who could see the urgent need to protect all this. His conversion to underwater cameraman came on the road to Aldinga Beach when he first started spearfishing. Back then he made his own snorkel and mask and underwater housing for his trusty Bell and Howe camera.
Once I got down here and swam with the seals, I mean, once again I was hooked. That was back in 1952. And of course when I came over here and swam with the seals, well, it was only natural to take the underwater camera out there and shoot some film underwater.
In a new century, a new boardwalk, named after the man who made this his second home. Now he and I and grandson Bo join Ranger Mel Berris in the controlled group set to allow these mammals as much rest as possible.
We've actually followed them with satellite trackers and timed depth recorders to see how deep they dive as well.
How deep?
A male this size can actually dive to a depth of 275 metres per dive. So it's a lot of hard work while they're out at sea. What we're finding, they're going up to at least 30 kilometres out to sea, so they're actually making their way to the continental shelf. And what we've also found is that they don't tend to sleep while they're at sea, so that for that 2 to 3 days they're actually awake the whole time.
So that's why they're asleep out here?
That's right.
To look at them here, you'd think a fillet of whiting wouldn't melt in their mouth. But Don knows differently, and his story of the couple who were attacked explains why we're kept at a distance, especially from the new mums.
They backed away and the woman fell over in the sand and the cow seal bit her on the calf, and her husband went to assistance and he fell over in the sand and the cow seal bit him on the hip. So yeah, it was a bit unfortunate.
Today it's the youngsters who give each other plenty of lip, and the tiny pups just watch in awe.
And I notice the little pup looks a bit wary of some of the activity going on. This is all new to him.
Yeah, well, the thing is, they can get injured, actually. If a couple of bulls decide to have a fight and there's a young pup there, I mean, they can roll on them or anything, you know.
Yeah.
They can injure them. Yeah.
For a bloke who spent 2 days a week here for 18 years, the fascination with Seal Bay
never wanes.
Well, it's one of the few places in the world, actually, that you can actually walk amongst the seals or get quite close to them and watch them in their natural state. The best thing to do, really, is to just sit quietly somewhere and let the seals do their own thing.
Seal Bay is located about 90 kilometres from the Penashore Ferry Terminal. A pass costs $10.50 per adult and will get you onto the beach via the Don Dixon Boardwalk.
Thank you.